a velmi mě těší, že vás mohu přivítat na tomto pořadu o slovinských ohlasech díla Václava Havla. Tento pořad pořádáme společně s velvyslanectvím Slovinské republiky. Já mezi námi vítám jeho excelenci Leona Maka, velvyslance Slovinské republiky v České republice, a o díle Václava Havla a jeho uvedeních ve Slovinsku k nám přijeli promluvit vzácní hosté, pan profesor Koniš, a který je divadelním vědcem, a jeho paní literární historička doktorka Hodižová. For those of you who don't understand Czech and understand that I think this is an event dedicated to the legacy of the work of Václav Havel in Slovenia. It's a critical work, and particular we organize it together with the embassy of the Slovenian, embassy of Slovenia, His Excellency Ambassador Leon Mark, who was so kind enough to work on the preparations with us, and we have guests from Slovenia, Professor Boniš and his wife, Madame Boniš, and they will introduce the stagings and performances of Václav Havel's place in Slovenia. I will now ask Ambassador Mark, poprosím pana vyslance Marka, aby řekl několik mluvných slov, a přeji vám příjemné odpoledne na večer.
Vážený pane Žentovský, vážený pane Topole, spoštovaný profesor Koniš, profesorica Koniš, spoštovaný gospod Burger, dámy a pánové, gospodin gospodje, vidíme slovenský prostor. Loni se mi dostal do rukou spodek, který u příležitosti steho výročí výuky slovenistiky na Karlové univerzitě vydala skupina neunavných studentů pod vedením profesorky Alenky Jensterle Podržanové a Andreja Kruna. Kromě jiného je v něm také uveden příspěvek profesora Poniža a Katje Mikulko-Ponižové o inscenacích divadelných her Václava Havla v Slovinsku. Osobně bylo pro mě velmi zajímavé sledovat, jak Havlova dráma dosahují sestupu a pádu v souvislosti se změnami politického ovzduší v tehdejší Jugoslávii nebo v Slovinsku. Žili jsme o trochu lépe než naši čeští přátelé, o trochu svobodněji, což s hrdostí užívala jak opozice, tak i oficiální představitelé. Dnešní události se naše velvyslanectví uchrání v roku Václava Havla. Existuje proto řada důvodů. Nejdříve ten nejdůležitější. V době levicového a pravicového populismu, který dnes tak říkajíc objímá celou Evropu, je třeba vzhlédnout zpět k evropským duchovním velikánům, jakým Václav Havel bez pochyby byl. Vzpomínáme také na všechny slovenské literáty, kteří podobně jako Václav Havel bojovali za demokracii ve Slovinsku. Mnozí z nich byli Havlovi známi a přátelé, jež si uvědomovali důležitost společného středoevropského kulturního prostoru. Letos si připomínáme 25. výročí nezávislosti Slovinska. Proto si v tomto kontextu přejeme upozornit na slovinský příspěvek demokratizaci střední Evropy. Díky způsobu získání nezávislosti pokládáme příspěvek za specifický originál. Nezapomeňme, že nám právě demokratizace a Evropská unie otevřela cestu k oživení česko-slovinské vzájemnosti, jež byla před stolety pro oba národy tak významná. Děkuji panu Michalu Žantovskému a panu Jakubu Polovi a také pracovníkom Michovným za hostitelství slovinské události tu v Knihovně Václava. Děkuji také panu profesoru Ponižovi a jeho manželce za představení slovinsko-české herečky Nataši Burger, která přečte několik odstavců ze slovinských překladů Havlových děl. Děkuji také Andrejovi Šurlovi za souhrn přednášky v češtině. A rovněž děkuji vám všem za účast. Přeji vám příjemný slovinský Havlův večer. Now we're going to listen to in Slovenian a few samples from some of the Havel's works in Slovenian.
Same sladke besede za vas. Ampak vi se lahko to pripuščite, ker ti vam se ne more nič zgoditi. Za vas je vedno zanimanje, vi znate zmerno poskrbeti za to. Vi ste zgoraj, čeprav ste spodaj. Medtem pa se navaden človek tukaj muči in ima od tega en drek. In nič ne doseže in vsi se posirjajo nam in vsi pometajo z njim in vsi ga hrulijo in nobenega življenja nima. In na koncu gospodje še reče o njem, da nima načel. Dobro službo v skladišču to bi vzel od mene, da bi pa vzel tudi malo tiste svinjarije, v kateri se moram dan za dnem valjati, a to ti pa ne paše več. Vi vsi ste preveč pametni, preveč dobro ste vse preračunali, predobro znate poskrbeti zase. Načela, načela. Kje pa, da jih ne bi ščitili za svoje načela? Vam se namreč sjajno obnesejo, vi jih namreč sjajno prodajete, vi namreč z njimi lepo zaslužite. Vrsta načela preživljajo. Kaj pa jaz? Jaz jih lahko dobim za nje le po grbi. Vi imate zmerno možnosti, ampak kakšne možnosti imam jaz? Za me nihče ne poskrbi. Mene se nihče ne boji. O meni nihče ne piše, meni nihče ne pomaga. Za me se nihče ne zanima. Jaz sem dobro kvečemu za to, da ustvarjam gnoj, iz katerega bojo zrasla ta vaša načela. Da iščem ogrete prostore za vaše junaštvo in zato na koncu požanjem lepo smeh. Ti se boš enkrat vrnil med svoje igralke, da se boš važil, da si ga posode, junak boš. Kaj pa jaz? Kaj se lahko jaz vrnem? Kdo me bo? Kdo bo cenil moja dejanja? Kaj imam jaz od življenja? Kaj me čaka? Kaj? Samo nekaj vam bom povedal, Ferdinand. Če sem se jaz nehote navadil na sprijeno misel, da je morala stvar disidentov, potem ste se tega, ne da bi se sploh zavedali, navadili tudi vi. In zato še na misel ni prišlo, da se lahko zdijo tudi meni nekatere vrednote pomembnejše od mojega sedanjega položaja. Kaj pa, če bi hotel biti končno tudi jaz svoboden človek? Kaj, če bi tudi jaz hotel obnoviti svoje notranje poštenje in bi vrgel sebe ta kamen ponižanja? Pa sploh ni prišlo na misel, da nara čakam prav na tale trenutek že dolga leta. Ste me kratko in malo enkrat za vsej uvrstili med brezupne primere, s katerimi nima smisla poskušati karko. In zdaj, ko ste ugotovili, da tudi mene zanima usoda drugih, vam je čisto o mojem podpisu kar tako ušlo. Tak, vendar ste se takoj strezili in se jih začeli brž opravičevati. Ali sploh veste, kako me s tem ponižujete? Kaj pa, če tudi jaz že dolgo čakam na priložnost za dejanje, ki bo iz mene spet naredilo moža, mi vrnilo notranji mir, fantazijo, humor, da se mi pred travmami ne bo več treba zatekati k marelicam in magnolijam. Kaj, če bi tudi jaz rad dal prednost resničnemu življenju in se vrnil iz naročenega pismenstva in televizije lažne kulture spet v svet umetnosti, ki ni nikomor sušnja. Še en odlomek iz igre Protest. Ne bodite no tako skromni, Ferdinand, sej vas spremljam. Če bi delal vsak to, kar vi, bi bile naše razmere čisto drugačne. Zelo važno je, da imamo vsaj nekaj ljudi, ki se ne bojijo povedati resnice na glas, ki se zavzemajo za druge, ki imenujejo stvari s pravim imenom. Mogoče bo zvenelo malo patetično, ampak zdi se mi, da ste si vi in vaši prijatelji naložili skoraj nečloveško nalogo prenesti skozi današnje močvirje ostanke moralne zavesti. Res da je nitka, ki jo spredate, tanka, ali mara prav na njej visijo upi, da se bo naše ljudstvo prerodilo. In še zadnji, to je iz igre Skušnjava v prevodu Jaroslav Skušnji. Če človek iz srca prežene Boga, samo napravi prostor v hudiču. Mar ni to ponosno početje, pri tem imam v mislih čedalje bolj slepo samovoljo mogočnikov in čedalje bolj slepo pokoščino podložnikov, ki ga današnji svet zganja pod zastavo znanosti in čega rahlo groteskni zastavonoše smo nas od zadnje tudi mi sami. Pravo, pravo za to hudičevo delo. Hudič je, kot vemo, mojster v pretvarjanju in nije domiselnejše preobleke od te, ki mu jo ponuja novomeško prezverstvo. Najhvaležnejši manjivrski prostor se je hudiču nujno odprl tisti hip, ko so ljudje prenihali verjeti vam. Oprostite mi, tolikšna odkritost, Marketa, a vsega tega ne zmorem več zadržati v sebi. Kako mu drugem razen vam bi se lahko tukaj izpovedal.
and gentlemen, dear friends, admirers of great men, playwright Václav Havel. I can speak about him for hours, but because our time is limited, I will try to sum little facts which are crucial for not only Havel's relations with Slovenian culture, but also for his position in Central Europe. My speech was made on the base of aforementioned paper we prepared with my spouse for the conference, which was, I think, 2 years or 3 years ago, in honor of 100th anniversary of teaching Slovene language and literature on Charles University. There has been a growing sensation of confusion in me ever since the day I accepted the invitation of the Slovenian ambassador, his Leon Marz, to participate in the Slovenian Day celebrating the memory of a great man, playwright and statesman. This was organized to honor an extraordinary person, playwright, by the institution which carries his name and keeps the respectful memory of everything he has done. I'm wondering when, in the heart of the Czech Republic, what I'm to say about one of the greatest Czech people, without whom not only Czech, but also European history, above all in Central Europe, would be different. How should I introduce to the experts a person who recorded history so accurately that each and every word in his place, as well in his essays and other writings, is a sign of accurate and consistent loyalty to the principles which should be the principles of all times and all democratic states. I can only critique him from a distant proximity, which falls into the category of Slovenian and Czech cultural context. And this context has lasted with short hiatuses from the Romantic era onwards. It has been rich and diverse, as well as very inspiring for many Slovene and Czech poets. Slovene and Czech contact, as is no coincidence, highly influenced drama. The first Slovenian playwright, Anton Tomáš Linhart, was Moravian on his father's side. His father was from Ivančice near Brno. What is more, Czech actors and actresses and directors helped professionalize Slovene National Theater at the end of the 19th and beginning of the 20th century. And Čapek's Rosum's Universal Robots was some of the most viewed plays between the two wars, not only professional staging, but also by amateur groups. However, one of the brightest chapters in the story of this cultural context is the chapter about Václav Havel. Especially in the time of totalitarianism, this is a complicated, often bitter, but also comical narrative, in the center of which is the story of Havel's drama and its liberating strength. It is a tale about his drama's way into the world after having been banned at home, after having been chased away from theaters. Václav Havel entered the consciousness of Slovenian people through his plays, which took to the Slovenian stages when the dark times of so-called normalization and ruthless repression of dissidents started in his own home. His plays spoke to us all those years until the moment when the single-mindedness in Central and Eastern Europe, maintained by the Soviet tanks, secret political police, and, as Kaul pointed out, the indifferent passiveness of the silent majority came down like a house of cards. This was a time when, after nearly a half a century, half European nations started learning again about democracy, which was easier for the Czech nation, since it had men like Havel and his peers from Charter 77. The story about staging Havel plays on Slovenian stages and in other republics of former Yugoslavia is tragic and inspiring at the same time. It is tragic, since in his homeland, as we pointed out, the playwright became a political prisoner, enemy of the state number one, and a known person. Yet in Slovenia, he was staged numerous times, including in the Slovene National Theater in Ljubljana. And this happened in a country which banned, locked up, and impeded its own authors. However, was not problematic. This is a paradox which I cannot explain adequately enough. Was it mere ignorance of the authorities, or more likely, it was a paramount evidence of how liberal a land of workers' self-management is? The highest party ideologist Edward Kardel said once, I quoted, "The Communist Party cannot guarantee happiness to its citizens. They have to create their own happiness." This sentence could have been taken from one or another Havel place. However, down came the Berlin Wall, the regimes in Central Europe collapsed one after another, the Velvet Revolution happened in Czechoslovakia. This was the time when the playwright and the author had to become a politician and a statesman. We know that these functions were not his joy, that he was aware of what gap there was between politicians and poets, statesmen and authors, between presidents and playwrights. He was an intellectual too loyal to himself to dispel his own doubts about the purity of political games to be able to step on the political stage free of moral dilemmas. And yet he still became a president of two countries, first Czechoslovakia, and after a civil breakup, he was the first president of the Czech Republic. In these times, Slovenians, who to this day still haven't yet mastered democracy, came to know this other and different Havel, the author and dissident who tried to apply all the bitter and yet incredibly valuable experience of his fight for justice, truth, and an individual's dignity into the new times. These new times soon showed their hypocrisy and belief. Those who were a part of the old system soon again appeared in the public office. During turning points, they laid down a law, and when things settled, they started playing their new roles as Democrats. The Slovenian homage to Václav Havel, the playwright, the dissident, and the politician, is not merely all of his plays, which were staged on Slovenian professional stages, but also all the records by drama experts about his drama, theater, and the dissident campaigns in which he participated. A very special homage was an exhibition in the Slovenian Theater Museum, now Slovenian Theater Institute, in November 1999, 6 years after Havel paid a state visit to Ljubljana in Slovenia. The exhibition with the title Václav Havel, Citizen and Playwright, was organized by the Arts and Theater Institute from Prague and the mentioned Slovenian Theater Museum, and it showed how ingrained the playwright and dissident Havel was in the Slovenian cultural consciousness. Further evidence of this consciousness and campaigns is a catalog which recorded Havel's journey to Slovenia as well as other European and world stages. There is also a photograph of Havel visit to the Slovene Writers Association in it. This visit, I can show you this catalog and this picture. This visit was an event which was not planned by protocol and was Havel's personal request, which showed that he never stopped being an author who constantly checked and noticed the consciousness of humanity and its civilization self-image, which was his basic human dimension. I was present in this spontaneous meeting. I remember his tired face, but lively speech, his witty remarks, and last but not least, his remarks and thanks of everything we had done, as he stressed not only for him personally, but mostly for freedom and human dignity of those who never accepted the heartlessness of the regime and repressive institutions. Once again, I have to return to the catalog, this catalog you have in hands. There is no shortage of information and photographs in it, which testify of a lively presence of the playwright personality and his work among Slovenian people, or as Ivo Svetina, the former director of Slovenian Theatre Museum and himself also a playwright and poet, wrote, I quote it, "The life and work of Václav Havel, the former stagehand at the Divadlo na Zábradlí and now the president of Czech Republic, serve as a paradigmatic image of the intellectual and artist 20th century. His artistic work has earned an undisputed authority and reputation, although for this he had to pay a high, indeed an excessive price. The frequency of performances of his dramatic works around the world reflected the fact that he always spoke the human language that was understandable both to the authorities as well as to those who were downtrodden and humiliated. The former were afraid of his language and locked up its authors, while the latter identified with his Vaniek, the universal hero of European theater in the second half of the 20th century, a theater which could no longer produce antique tragedies, but which could wave from the tragic fate of individuals and dramatic figures which were as convincing to the audience in the barn near Krobovi, 30 kilometers from Prague, as they were to the audience in the Tangala Theater in Manila, Philippines." In the catalog, another writer, Slovene Drago Janča's recollection can also be found. He also experienced the stern hand of the communist regime, albeit not to such an extent or with such amplitude. In one single lucid paragraph in his essay, he sums up not only Havel's fate, but the fate of all those who experienced the revenge of those in power who detested an individual and his dignity and ruthlessly punished any kind of resistance from the politics to the Adriatic. I quote it again. Havel's theatrical and social story, from far away and with the eye turned toward the quickly departing time we have lived out, seems beautiful and magic. It was written ironically, as you can imagine soon. Diseases, imprisonment, manual work, chicanery, great and small, constant surveillance, evasion of friends, pressure exerted on his family, the ugly things he had to endure in order to live his history in his one and only life distort the pretty picture. It even seems that the nasty aspects the trials undergone were there for one reason alone, to teach the lesson about the pure, brave individual and his spiritual growth, liberating the oppressed nation, the whole oppressed nation. End of quotation. This is a verbalized truth about the personality which bravely opened the chances for a different understanding of civil liberties and responsibilities in the face of state institutions and drama. When my spouse and I were invited to participate in the symposium which was mentioned before, we thought it logically, owing to our professional specializations, to present the staging of our plays on Slovene stages between 1969 and 1990. Five of his plays were staged 7 times during those years. However, The Garden Party, translated as early as 1963, this is the first translation of Havel et al., by Draga Ahačić, who is now 96 years old, and still alive, and who very deeply entered into the Slovene theater, especially into the avant-garde and experimental theater. This play has unfortunately never been staged. After 1990, Havel was staged once again, and this time in the Slovenian theater in Trieste, Italy, in Trieste and neighbor are living is living Slovene minority, but this minority is so strong that it has its own theater. In this theater in Trieste was staged audience and two one-acts, audience and protest in 2004 with the director Dušan Nakar, who was also director of the last performance in 1990. I will show you one piece of this performance, but I'm sorry because the sound of the copy is very bad, but you probably know how it's very so good that there will be no problem. Audience was the first text translated anew by Nives Rittrich, who also modernized the second one-act play for the Trieste staging. After it was translated for the first time in 1981 by Zdenka Jerman. A year before that, in 2003, the collection of books called Dramaticon, a source of the most important foreign plays of the 20th century, published Audience and Unveiling, both translated by Nives Rittrich as well, and with a preface written by Boris Anovak. Anovak was at late 80s, he was a dramaturgist in National Theater, and he was also responsible for the one or two dramatization of Havel's plays. Novak's preface is, apart from individual records in the theater programs and in the catalog of the aforementioned exhibition from 1999, the most intelligent text which discusses Havel's drama. However, Novak does not only discuss the structure of Havel's drama and its inner logic, but also the question of the relationship between drama as art and dissidence as a political stance. He correctly determines that a large part of so-called dissident literature loses its power after the fall of communism, which of course is not true of Havel's work. He adds, I got it from the first time. On this level, Hubble by far surpasses the limitations of the type of dissidents which developed in the time of the communist rule in Central and Eastern Europe. Vaněk, the anti-protagonist, as Novak called him, anti-protagonist in several of Hubble's plays, among others in one act play, Audience and Unveiling, is far from any sort of moralism and puritanism. Quite the opposite. Preaching is not something he does well. He understands everything and everyone, even those who are expanding him. Such dramaturgy enables him with a much deeper insight into the structure of the repressive social system, as do the declarative writings of less talented authors. Quotation. And the Slovenian publishing house, Lohorjeva Družba, which was established in 1851 and is thus the oldest one among Slovenian publishing houses, translated Hubble's essay The Power of the Powerless as early as 1994. This political essay, written in 1978 and leading amongst Hubble's key essays, and which was published by the very same institution we are in at the moment, is a fundamental text for the understanding of how humans stand. One of the editors of the collection, Daniel Krohmer, entitled his preface to the essay The Invitation to Read Hubble's Essays. Since they are still current and haven't lost their prophetic insight into the source of nations of this part of the world. These essays put him at least part of the answer to the question of why communism was kept here for such a long time. With his lucid depiction of how the system worked, Hubble comes close to Drago Jančar and his essay The Fleshpot of Egypt from 1995. They both discuss the dilemma of the commoner living in the communist oppression who sacrifices his full stomach for human rights and spiritual freedom. And this commoner waits for somebody else to do for him what was supposed to happen between 1989 and 1991 from Berlin to Bucharest. And these others fulfilled their task with the intellectual strength with which they made European new history. As much as it is still relevant to stage Hubble's space, seeing the messages still there between Orwellian and Kafkaian timelessness, it is even more relevant to still read Hubble's essays, particularly The Power of the Powerless. This essay is not just the author and the dissident, credo, but the message to future generations. Owing to everything that history had told us about totalitarianism, especially since the archives have been opened to the public, and also owing to my own personal experience, I'm positive that no relativizing of Václav Havel's artistic opus can change the course of history. Havel's plays, the memorandum and audience are without doubt anthological texts of European absolute drama. New sets of Havel plays are a matter of understanding of both the past with its absurdities and the present with its labyrinths and old new dilemmas. This too is an essential part of Slovenian and Czech cultural context, which intelligent young people are now taking into their own hands. But hence, many of them have neither historical recollection nor the wish to have it. From my journey around other Eastern European countries, I'm afraid that the situation is similar there as well, which is why it is so important to persist
is the preservation of historical memory, especially of the historical memory of people like Václav Havel and his friends. Thank you very much.
Italy, data from the Jakarta Museum in Turkey, and architecture has some other data some progress in India.
Thank you.
Vi ste vi na prvo pomoć kao moje resulje, vi ste. Vi ste osobno i da ti se da ti. Vi ste vi. Gdje je njegove prestičnosti na svijetu? Ja, ja sam se kada ne mogu da budu skupra. Co to vlastně je. My chtěli ještě nemíl čas povědět, kdy to bylo. A pak je to režíro duša mná.
May I answer in English? It's with Slovene, as you know, with Slovene television, it's a big problem. They have tapes, especially tapes of artistic events, re-recorded. They have erased these tapes because in one period there was a lack of tapes. So they use old tapes, these correctly recorded theater plays, openings of exhibitions, interviews, domestic and foreign artists. They simply erased and put something else. Recorded something else. So maybe that on a cover of one tape is still the title of Havel's play or another play, but the content is completely different. I was also asking television to send me some information about what was recorded, when and how, and I never received the answer.
Si moram prašat mene, jer sam ti nije informacije, sam ti dal. Ja sam hodio, ali bi puno hoće vidjeti, Duša Mlaka, študentsko gledanje, premijera študentske gledanje, iz leta N70. Kad se ona mi dođe u studiju, ti moram hoće si ti pisati,
know that also some amateur groups played stage Havel's plays, but there is no documentation about these events. Maybe that someone will, by pure luck, will find something. Maybe, maybe not. A lot of information is lost from these days. Nobody was thinking that such a material will be one day important for someone.
What I suggest is the glasses have been filled with Slovenian wine, there's some Slovenian cheese and Slovenian salami. So I invite everyone to make use of